Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'll show you how to solve MCAT-style questions involving fractions, ratios, percentages, and proportions without a calculator. You may find yourself faced with a question like this. Find the molarity of a solution made by dissolving 35 grams of NaBr in 500 milliliters of water. The science portion of this question will be tackled in my chemistry series at leiaforsci.com/MCATchemistry, but for now let's focus on the math. In setting up this equation, we're trying to find molarity, which is moles per liter. But we first have to solve for moles and then for liters, which results in many different fractions. To solve for moles, we set up the dimensional analysis in a form of given times ratio, where 35 grams is the given, and we multiply that by 1 mole of NaBr over the molar mass. On the periodic table, NaBr is 22.99 for sodium and 79.9 for bromine. On the MCAT, we round that to 23 plus 80. 23 plus 80 is much easier to work with, and that gives us 103 grams. Grams cancel, giving us a molar value, and then we want to divide all of that by the volume. We have 500 milliliters times the ratio of 1 liter over 1,000 milliliters. Use the trick of canceling out zeros. In this case, we have 5 over 10 or 1 over 2. And our ultimate calculation is 35 times 1 over 103 divided by 1 over 2. If you have to divide fractions, you multiply by the reciprocal. So we'll flip 1 over 2 to become 2 over 1 and set it up to solve. The reason I didn't solve the individual components is because if I have to run through all the equations, it's going to take too long. But if I can find a way to simplify, I'll save myself the time and save myself the calculations. 35 over 103 is approximately a third, because 33 over 100 is 1 over 3. On the MCAT, we're allowed to round if it's close enough, and so I'll divide each one by approximately 35, so I'll get 1 over 3. My new simplified equation is 1 over 3 times 2 over 1, which is simply 2 over 3. This is a fraction that you should know, which is equal to 0.67 molar. Punching the exact values into the calculator, I get 0.68 molar, which on the MCAT is close enough. And how did I save myself all the math? I set up one series of fraction times fraction times fraction, found what I can simplify or cancel out, leaving me with a minimal number of calculations that I can easily do in my head. Now, say you do find yourself having to come up with the value of a fraction. I don't like fractions because they're hard to put into longer calculations, so I like to turn them into decimals or whole numbers. You should be comfortable with the numerical value of fractions ranging from 1 over 1 all the way to 1 over 10. And if you're not comfortable with this, download my math cheat sheet on my website, leiaforsci.com/MCATmath. When it comes to percentages, you want to treat it the same way as a fraction. Percent literally means per 100 or over 100. For example, you may find yourself faced with the following question. Find the percent D character in a molecule that has sp3D hybridization. The first thing you want to do is set up the ratio. Anytime you're asked for a percent, solve for the part over whole, where the whole is going to be your 100 value, and then you multiply it by 100%. In this case, we're asked for D character, so the D is our part, and we only have 1 D. The whole will be the total number of orbitals that combine to form this hybrid. In this case, we have 1s, 3p, and 1d for a total of 5. So we have 1d over 5 total, and that means we're solving for 1 over 5. Now, you should recognize this as 0.2, and multiplying by 100, since 100 has two zeros, we move the decimal two spaces over to the right, which is a trick I mentioned in an earlier video, giving me an answer of 20%. If you're not comfortable with this method, you can also try turning your fraction into a number that is directly divided by 100. So let's show it on this example first. If we have 1 over 5, ask yourself, how do I turn the 5 into a 10 or into 100? I'll do it step by step, but I want you to be able to do this in your head. If we have 1 over 5, to turn 5 into 10, I need to do 5 times 2. So I'll multiply this by 2 over 2, because 2 over 2 is equal to 1, so I don't change the identity or the value of the number. 1 times 2 is 2, 5 times 2 is 10. It's very easy to go from 10 to 100, I just multiply by 10 over 10. 2 times 10 is 20, 10 times 10, is 100. 20 per 100 is 20%, and that gives us 20% again. Now, for something like this, you don't want to go through the steps. But what if you're faced with a fraction such as 7 over 33? This is a lot more complicated to do if you try to do this the long way or try to do this in your head. But if you ask yourself, can I turn 33 into 100? This becomes much easier. 33 is a third of 100. So what I have to do is multiply by 3 over 3. 7 times 3 is 21. 33 times 3 is 100, and my answer is approximately 21%. Another question type that uses fractions is proportions. If you have a proportion of A compared to B, that's simply A divided by B, and once again, we're looking at a fraction. For example, in a question like this, what is the gravitational force on a planet if the mass is 3 times the mass of Earth, but its radius is only 2 times the radius of Earth? I'll address the science of this question in my physics videos, which you can find at layerforsci.com/mcatphysics. But let's look at the math here. The equation for gravitational force is F equals gmm over r squared, where one of the m values refers to the mass of the planet, the other is the mass of an object. What we want to do is compare the two equations, one for the force of Earth and one for the force of the planet. So we'll put that in a different color. We have gmm over r squared. And we're setting up a proportionality. Anything that shows up the same on both, meaning if we have a value that is the same on both sides of the proportion, we can cross it out. The first mass refers to mass of an object, get rid of it. The g value we're not looking at, so get rid of that. We're solving for force, or we're solving for the new force value. So all we're left with is m over r squared, and we'll assume that the mass of Earth is considered 1, and therefore the mass of the planet is 3, because it's 3 times the 1 mass of Earth. The radius of the planet is 2 times that of the radius of Earth, so our Earth is going to be 1. And here's how we set it up. The new m over r squared is equal to the following. Mass of the planet is 3 times mass of Earth. Radius of the planet is 2 times the radius of Earth, but remember that we have to square it. So the square is going to square both the 2 and the r, and this gives us a new value of 3 over 4, because 2 squared is 4. And that means the gravitational force on this new planet will be 3 over 4, which is 75%. Now let's use the trick above to prove that it's 75%. 3 over 4, you should recognize 1 over 4 is 0.25, and multiply that by 3 is 0.75. Or you can say that to go from 4 to 100 is times 25 over 25. 3 times 25 is 75, 4 times 25 is 100, and that is 75%, that of the force of Earth. Be sure to join me in my next video, where I show you how to solve MCAT-style trigonometry, angle, and vector-style problems without a calculator. Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below, or by visiting my website, layerforsci.com/mcattutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at mcatexamstrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, mcatexamstrategy.com.